What's up guys, Senaid here from CodingPassiveIncome.com. In today's video tutorial I'll talk about MySQL procedures. So procedures we use when we have some part of the code that we use all the time, and it will be much simpler just to write one procedure and just call it over and over again. In the first part of this tutorial I will show you on my whiteboard how to create procedure and what you need to know in order to be able to create one. And in the second part of this video tutorial I will use my PC and workbench and show you exactly how to do that inside MySQL. So let's do it. So now I'm here at my whiteboard and I'm going to show you how to create one procedure. So procedure we use when we same like functions in any other language. So if we do something all the time, we can use procedures that we do that for us so that we don't need to write the code each time. Or when we have a lot of things to do and we just want to run procedure, call it once and it will do it for us. So for example, if we have this table and we want just basic example to select everything from these users, we can create procedure that will always print out all the users that we have. So I will start here. Let's say we will write like this delimiter. And now this line of code just means that we want to change the default one, which is semicolon, so the MySQL interpreter will not execute you line by line, but and he will execute all the commands that are in between this delimiter and the one that we'll write later here. So let's move on. So we'll say create procedure. And now we need to specify the name of this procedure, and let's say just all users. And now we need to continue here. We will just say begin. And now here we need to close this. So I will just say here end. And now again this sign that we used here. And now we need to change the delimiter to the default one again. Okay. And now between this begin and the end, we can write the commands that we want to use inside this procedure. So let's say we will just write the command that will show all this data, and as you already know it is select everything from users. Okay, and that's it. Now we have created procedure all users, and when we call it, this command will execute select everything from users, and that's it. And we will call this procedure by call all users, and that's it. And when this execute, we'll have this data. And as you can see, this is one very basic procedure and nothing too advanced. I just wanted to show you the basic how to create some procedure. Now, let's say we want to do something that we'll need to calculate something inside the database. So for example, we will create a procedure that will have three parameters. First parameter will be the number that we want to multiply by all the numbers from the minimum and maximum. So for example, like this, we will pass min, max, total, and x. And for every, okay, so minimum will go from the minimum to the max, and for example this x will be always the same. So for example, if we pass the parameter 5 and say calculate the total from 1 to 5, and the total formula is total equal total plus minimum multiplied by x. And now if we try this, it will be, for the first total is equal to 0, and 0 plus 1 multiplied by 5 is 5. Now when we have minimum change for 2, 2 is less than 5, and now 2 multiplied by 5 is 10, plus 5 is 15. Now when we have 3, 3 is less than 5, and 3 multiplied by 5 is 15, plus 15 is 30. 4, 4 is less than 5, 5 multiplied by 5 is 20, plus 30 is 50. So now if in this procedure we pass the parameters x equal 4, min equal 1, max equal 5, the result will be 50. Okay, and now we need to write this procedure so that user can pass any x and any minimum and any max. So let me just clean this whiteboard and I will show you how to write this procedure. So now we need to write again the same code, which is delimiter create procedure. And now the name will be calculate. And now this function will receive three parameters. First is x, which is type integer. Then we have minimum, which is type integer. And we have maximum, which type is integer. And I'll continue here. Now I say begin. Okay. And here I will just close and now switch the delimiter. Okay, so now first thing that we need to know is we need to create variable for this procedure that we just total. So we will create declare total integer. And now inside this procedure we will have variable total, and there we will be able to store some result. Now we need to initialize this variable, so we'll say set total equal 0. And now I'm going to show you how to use the loop that will go from the minimum to the maximum. So we'll say while min less than max do, and here we need to close this while, so we'll say end while. Okay, and now we need to increase this total like we already said, so we'll say again set total equal total plus minimum multiplied by x. And now we need to increase this minimum for 1, so we'll say set min equal min plus 1. So now we can try this once again just to be sure that our code is correct. So if we have minimum and we have total, let's see what will happen. So let's say that x is equal 5 again, okay, and the maximum is equal 5 again. So now when we go through this code, we will use minimum is set to the 1. So it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And now when we see here, total is at the moment 0. So 0 plus 1 multiplied by 5 is 5. Then we increase minimum, now it's 2. And 2 is less than 5. So total is now 5 plus 2 multiplied by 5 is 10, which is 15. Then we have 3 multiplied by 5 is 15 plus 15 is 30. 4 is less than 5. 4 multiplied by 5 is 20 plus 30 is 50. And now 5 is not less than 5, and we won't calculate this. And we will finish with this. And here we can then just say select total so that we show the result. And that's it. So this is just one example how we can, using procedure, calculate something, let's say, very complicated, but it's really not. But we can use procedure to do anything in the MySQL. So let me now show you on the PC inside the workbench how we can use procedure and create stuff like this. So now I'm here at my PC and I will show you how to create procedure inside the MySQL workbench. As you can see, I have already opened and I have written the query that will just select membership system database. Okay, and now this is the command that will just show that all the data that we have inside users table. So now I'm going to write just the first basic procedure that will just execute this command. So we will say delimiter. Okay, and now we'll say create procedure, and now we'll give it some name. Let's say all users. It won't have any parameter here, and we will just say begin and again we will just switch delimiter to the default one, and here we will just execute this same command. Okay, and that's it. Now let's execute this code. Okay, it's successful. And now here on the left side, if we refresh, you can see here for the table users, we have some stored procedures and it's called all users. Now if we call this procedure and let's say call all users, and if we execute this, you can see now that this query is executed just as we expected. Okay, so now let's write the previous example that we had on the whiteboard, the one which do some math. So we'll create again delimiter, create procedure, and let's say calculate integer, min integer, max integer. And we'll say begin and delimiter. Okay, and now we need to write the code. So first thing that we need to do is to declare variable total. So we say declare total and the type is integer. And now we need to set this variable total to the 0. Okay, and now we need to write some loop that will go through all numbers from the minimum to the maximum and do the math. So while min less than max do, and here we will just close this. And now here write the code set total equal total plus min multiplied by x. And now we will say set min equal min plus 1. Okay, And now let's execute this. Okay. And now if we refresh on the left side, we can see that we have now one more procedure, which is calculate. And now let's try to use it. So we'll say call calculate. And now here we'll say number is 5, minus 1, max is 5. And let's execute. And now as you can see, this command has executed, but actually nothing happened. We don't see any result. And the reason for that is because here we just calculate the result, but we don't print out any of these. So we'll need just to make small change inside the procedure. So before we do that, I want to show you command drop procedure calculate, and this procedure will just delete the procedure if you have. So execute, and now as you can see here on the left side, we don't have it anymore. So now if we change the procedure, we'll just say select total. Okay, and now let's create procedure again. And what if we now execute this? Now we have result total equal 50, just like we said on the whiteboard. What if we try for some different number? Let's say 10 and goes from 1 to 10. Let's execute, and that's it. So guys, pretty much that's it. It is pretty simple to use and create the procedures. You just have to understand some basics, which is that you need to switch delimiter, that you need first to create procedure and give it some name and define do you have, will your procedure receive any parameter or not, and that inside the begin and end part you can declare variables and you can use loops. Also you can use any other normal SQL query command. So guys, if you have any question, please comment below, and also it will be my pleasure if you can like and share this video. So until the next time, bye bye.